Hi, I'm Zoe Perkins. I'm one of the co-curators of the exhibition Raining Men, Fashions in Menswear, 1750 to 2015. Today, we're in the first gallery of the exhibition, and it's entitled Evolution Revolution. Now, oftentimes people say, why do you study fashion? What can we learn from it? And in fact, fashion is the mirror of our times. It reflects the social, the political, the economic, and the cultural issues of the day. And today I want to talk about one of the more interesting pieces and one of my favorite pieces in the exhibition that I think really captures this spirit. And that is this Zoot suit dating from the 1930s to 40s. Now, in the 1920s, the fashion was the English drape. It was a very slim silhouette and was very elegant. The Zoot suit was very different. The proportions were very robust and very exaggerated. And as you see here, the shoulders are extremely broad, the lapels are very wide, the sleeves are very full, and the jacket comes down to a very low fingertip length. Additionally, the pants are very high-waisted and very full because there are pleats that begin at the waist and fill out the knee area and then are pegged or capped with these cuffs at the ankle level. In this particular ensemble, the diameter of the fabric at the knee level is 47 inches. Now, while the origins of the Zoot suit aren't totally known, the Zoot suit is associated with jazz, jazz music, and swing clubs of the period. They were typically worn by African American, Jewish, and Latino youths. And they were very, very popular. Oftentimes these pieces were documented in newspaper articles, magazine articles, film, dance film at the time, as well as music. The lyrics, Zoot Suit for My Sunday Girl, was a very popular song. And while these pieces were very useful for dancing, as you can see, the pockets were very, very broad, and they were attached only at certain levels so that when the dancers swung around the dance floor, the pockets would swing out. So again, it was just another vivacious component of this suit. And while it was very popular, there were also some negative connotations associated with the Zoot suit. And one being the social unrest during World War II between some Hispanic males and military men in Los Angeles. And these youths also embraced this style. And as a result, the social unrest became known as the Zoot suit riots. Additionally, this fashion was popular again during World War II when there were the government was encouraging limitations or restrictions in fabric usage. So many people who wore Zoot suits were considered unpatriotic. So while there are there's a lot of documentation about these suits and we know a lot about them, one would think that there would be a lot of these around, and in fact, this is the only known complete ensemble of a Zoot suit that exists. Now, the Los Angeles County Museum of Art curators looked for several decades for a Zoot suit, and it wasn't until about 10 years ago that they found one at auction. And the history of this piece is that it came from the New Jersey area, so it is felt that it is likely that this piece was worn in Harlem. Again, one of the more rare pieces in this exhibition. I hope you will take the time, put it in your calendar to come see this exhibition. It's really a unique opportunity to see one of the best collections of men's fashions in the country or the world. And there are so many unique pieces. The exhibition closes in 2 weeks. It closes on Sunday, September 17th. And as usual, we are open free to the public on Fridays, and there are two free Fridays left. So again, put it in your calendar and have a dandy day.